Welcome to the Life's Necessities and Luxuries radio show. Today, our host, Dawn Marie Mutel, your Life's Commodities broker, will bring you fashion, beauty tips, business acumen, teach you where to find the life's greatest necessities and the finest luxuries. Now, here's Dawn Marie.
Hey, 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 it's Dawn Marie here. Welcome to another episode of Life's Necessities and Luxury. Today, I'm going to talk about a couple of ways that you can turn on your store power. You know, we all go through those moments in time where you start to feel a little drab and a little blah, and you're thinking, oh my gosh, I need a makeover. But not everybody can afford to go out and buy a whole new wardrobe or get a new life, right? So I'm going to talk about a couple of quick ways that you can kind of just amp up your life, your wardrobe, and feel really good about the things that you have and work with what you have. I always say to my clients, work with what you have. You might need to add a few more things, but you don't have to start over from scratch. So one of the first things I love for them to do is to go into your closet and take a full assessment of what's really there. And that may mean taking it all out so that you can create four different piles. One's going to be that you're going to keep, one that you're definitely going to donate, one that could be maybe you need to do some mending or some alterations, and the other one is going to be for donating. When you put them back into your closet, I really want you to put them in color coding so that you can start with your lightest to the darkest, and you're going to start with your blouses, and you're going to put your skirts and your pants. And even for suits, I'd like you to separate those as well, because I find that you can still use a suit as, you know, you may use the blazer, or you may use the slack, or you may use the skirt to it, and not as a suit. But really take a good look and try everything on and see if it still fits. If it was one of those trendy items, I'd say if it's really something that's a little too much, put it aside, maybe donate it or give it away to one of your friends or your family. There are a lot of things that you may find that are either going to be too big or too small. If they're too big, you can have them altered if it's something that you absolutely love. And if it's too small, possibly there's nothing you can do, but you may like the fabric of something that you might be able to cut the fabric and actually create something else. So if you know how to sew, maybe you can make a little pillow out of it or a sachet or something to, you could still keep that memento there, but you may not be using it as an actual piece of a wardrobe. Start with that and then make a list of the things that you find you may not have. For instance, let's say you just need a simple pair of black pants or a beige pant or a white pant, something that you can mix and match with other items in your wardrobe. Because having those main key pieces is really going to help you build a capsule wardrobe. For instance, you can have 9 pieces of clothing and make 35 outfits out of it. So think about that when you're shopping. And do you know your right colors? I would love to do a color match for you, so if you're interested, just email me at lifesnnl@gmail.com and we can do something by Skype if you're not in my town. Another thing is trying some new different makeup colors. You know, we kind of, as women, we seem to get stuck in a rut where we love our certain colors that we just wear year after year after year. There are so many products out there now that are new that actually can make a huge difference. So try and go into a counter and see if they can do some makeup color choices for you and try some new things, something that you would not normally wear that can really make a difference in your day-to-day look. Another great thing I love for people to do is to just take a mini daycation, as I love to call it. It could be an hour or two, but just somewhere that's relaxing or invigorating or just a lot of fun. Like maybe you just go to the batting cages and you hit some balls. It's really a great way to release some stress. Or maybe you just go out and do some golfing for the day, or you go play miniature golf without the kids, just you and your husband or you and your date or whatever, or even if it's by yourself, just to do something fun or go on the bumper cars. But I used to love to just go to amusement parks. It would make you feel like a kid again. You'd laugh, you'd scream your head off when you're going down the roller coaster. And you really feel invigorated. So do something that's really going to light your fire. Another great thing I always say is to fall in love again with your partner. And if you're not in love, fall in love with yourself all over again. Do some things that you used to do when you first started to date that you maybe no longer do. because, you know, after time, we all get a little stale and we forget how much fun we had with them in the beginning. So think about those days and try to come up with some of those fun things that you used to do together. But act like a kid and have some fun. Stop sweating all the small stuff, you know. Look in the mirror and think, wow, you know, I'm actually fun. Think about some of the fun things that you can actually do and be so that you don't feel so, I'm so serious all the time. You know, all the responsibility is on me, okay? Because you know what? You don't want to make for a dull girl, do you? Or a boy. Try a different route. If you always drive a certain way to work, I mean, I've done it several different times, and all of a sudden I come across a new store or a new shop or even just a new beautiful tree or a beautiful house that I had never seen before. And it's really something because it makes you look like, well, look at this. It's actually something fun to see, you know, and it just mixes it up a little bit. Do you take advantage of the sunrises and sunsets that happen every day? I try to because I find that they're one of the most amazing things that God has put on this earth for us to see every day and evening of our lives while we're on this planet Earth. So take advantage. Is there a place that you can go where you know has a great sunset that you can just drive to after work and just sit there? Even if you don't get out of your car, you could just sit there and look at it drop and look at all the beautiful colors in the sky and watch the birds fly by and just think of the peace and tranquility that it'll bring immediately into your life. Try doing it a few times a week. You'll be surprised, even if you're driving to work at 6 o'clock in the morning and the sun is rising. I always wonder how many people actually see that sunrise. So start noticing these things because they'll make you enjoy your life that much more and make it more hearty and enjoyable. Another thing I always talk about with my clients is to try to get in touch with your body and think about the things that it needs. It may be, you know, did you ever wonder when your body's saying, oh, you know, I really want some orange juice. Or maybe you need some vitamin C. So when it's craving something, it could be that you're depleted in that particular nutrient or supplement or whatever it might be. So think about those things. Listen to them, pay attention, and give it what it needs. If you're not drinking any water, drink more water. If you hate drinking water, I always say get a really pretty glass, add some fruit to it, whether it's lemons, limes, strawberries, anything that may make it more appetizing for you to pick up that glass and drink the water. Have you ever tried yoga? Yoga is an amazing practice, not only for your mind, but it does really amazing things for your body. It helps you stretch and get limber, and actually it just loosens up the joints. And, you know, we sit a lot of our day away. So for those of us who do sit at an office desk or what have you, we're not up and around, you have to stretch. And yoga is really a great and gentle way to do that. Start with the easier practices. Don't go jumping into something that's more intermediate because that you may get hurt. But check with your doctors, make sure that it's okay, and try it. You know, and if you don't feel comfortable going to a studio, rent out a tape from the library and try it at home. Get a CD out and check it out. We talked about makeup, but now what about your hair? Are you afraid of change, or are you somebody that's constantly changing your hair? For those of you who are constantly changing your hairstyle, I highly commend you ladies and you gentlemen out there. But for those of us who kind of get stuck in a rut, I'm one of those people where I get very comfortable with my hairstyle only because I've gone to so many different hairstylists and they've really dramatically changed it and they've done some great damage to it. So I get a little leery every time I see one. Just a color, like I will take color at home and just try to lighten it up a little bit or just cut my bangs myself and just do some kind of fun little hairstyles. I'll look at some tutorials on YouTube and try to copy it that way. But try trying something new because you may just find your new style and love it and everybody's going to be like, oh my God, that's so you. So give it a shot. Don't be afraid to try it because guess what? With hair, it just grows back. And if you don't want to take that risk, go to one of your local wig stores and just try on a couple of different wigs, whether it's the color, the cut, the style. Take a photo, see if you really like it, or buy one and wear it for a few days to see if that's something that you'd like to try out on a more permanent scale. I find one of the quickest ways when we were talking about makeup earlier to have a change is to actually try a new lipstick color. Yes, I know we all have our tried and trues, but like if you don't usually wear red, try to find the perfect red because everybody has, like if you have more of a cool undertone in your skin, which is more of a pink undertone, then try more of a berry red. And if you have more of a warm color tone, then try to go for more of a true red. Wearing red as a lipstick, it's just, immediately makes you feel more chic, more French, more fashionable. So make a statement and give it a try. And if it's fall and wintertime, the Berry family looks really nice during that time of year. And you can also wear it on your talons as well. So give your nails a little fun pop. Another quick and easy way to turn on your star power is to just add some more accessories to your life. And that could be a really fun earring, or it could be a necklace, earring, and a fun bracelet. Accessories can really make or break your outfits, so think about adding some new ones. And if you're always wearing something that's very dainty, try something a little bit more bold. You know, I love going to stores like H&M or Forever 21, where they have like these amazing sales in there all the time on accessories. So you're not really investing a whole lot of money, but you can try something a little bit more trendy and give it a shot. You know, you can try them on in the store, ask the salespeople what they may recommend for your body type. Because think about your body type when you do wear accessories, because just like with clothing, you want to find the right size accessory for your particular body type. So if you have a petite frame, stay with smaller sized items. And if you have a larger frame, then go for something that's a little bit larger and heavier and chunkier. I mentioned earlier about falling in love with your partner, but you know, do you go on date night with your love? Having those once a week date nights is so important to keeping the love alive in your relationship and keeping the romance going. So the one thing I do suggest that when you do go out that evening is to try not to talk about the bills, any kind of problems, or the children. Just talk about yourselves. Maybe you talk about your day, or maybe you talk about plans that you'd like to look at, some new goals that you may want to create and work on them together, you know. And this way, when you're on the same page, you can get a lot more done and you'll feel more connected to each other.
If you haven't had a chance to check out episode number 21, Happy National I Love My Feet Day, please be sure you do, because it covers all of your legwear and it will help you tremendously in that aspect.
What kind of shoes do you wear? I mean, are you always wearing the same type of shoe? Is it a flat? Is it something that's more on the comfortable side? You know, having sensible shoes is very important, but I think that there's something to be said for all the amazing shoe styles we have out there today. So if you cannot wear stiletto heels like myself because of my back injuries, I stopped wearing them. On occasion, I will wear them, but I look for more things that are like wedges and some strappy sandals so that they're a little bit more comfortable on my back, but they still look sexy. They still look pretty and feminine. And the kitten heel, which is a very tiny heel, it's about an inch high, they're actually making a comeback again. So check out your local stores. You can check Nine West, as you used to have a nice selection of those, or Lord & Taylor, maybe online. But they're a great way to still show that femininity, sexiness, and you don't have to like kill your back in the process. So check them out. I highly recommend them. Another great way to turn on your star power is, again, we all get stuck having our favorite fragrance. We may wear it forever, probably since our high school days, you know, and you find that one that you love and you'll just always have it in your repertoire. But I love trying out new fragrances because I do believe in aromatherapy, and our body chemistries change as well as we get older. Every 10 years, you know, our skin changes and so does our chemistry. So go to a fragrance counter at your local Macy's or, you know, Nordstrom store or what have you, and start checking out some new ones. Don't just spray them on the little cards that they give you, but actually put it on your skin and leave the store or take some samples home with you and try one on, one a day, so that you don't get your nose too confused of what's going on there. But try them out and see which one you like the best before you make that commitment, because perfumes are not cheap by any means these days. Find one that you love and see if your partner likes it, this way, because you don't want to offend them if they don't like it, and you love it, and if you want to wear it every day, and it really bothers them, so make sure that you both love it. Another quick and easy way to turn on your star power is to, if you do wear glasses, is to start wearing contacts. You know, have you ever thought about it? And even if you don't wear them all the time, at least maybe when you go out on your date night, or if you're just going out with your friends, try wearing your contacts instead of your glasses. And if you do wear glasses, do you also wear prescription sunglasses? Because I know I can't live without my prescription sunglasses. I'm in them like all the time, especially down here in sunny Florida. The sun is super bright, so you have to protect those beautiful eyes, right? So get yourself a pair if you don't have them. I find another thing to do is in your home. You know, we all want to have a very comfortable place to live and you want it to be beautiful. If you're a tea drinker or a coffee drinker like myself, I like to have a pretty little cup or mug or teacup at my desk when I'm working because it's just one of those simple little things to make you feel like, oh, it's not expensive, but you can get something that's really charming and it just makes you feel special. I can't explain it, but it's one of those little things that make a difference. So check that out and try it for yourself. Speaking of the home, I find I have to have fresh cut flowers in my home and at my desk all the time. And yes, if you go to floral shops, they can be quite pricey, but I found in my local supermarkets that they have a nice assortment of flowers, and they usually are very inexpensive. Sometimes they're like four bouquets for $12. So I get one little bouquet of these astromanias. It's a very delicate flower, but they seem to last around 2 to 3 weeks at a time. And I usually just cut them every week and give them some fresh water and some plant food. And I split them up. So I take some to work at my desk, and then I keep some on my table so that I get to see them every day. And they just look beautiful. And if you don't like flowers, then think about having a budding plant that may have a beautiful fragrance to them so that when you pass by it, you could just take a whiff of that beautiful scent. And again, aromatherapy is really key. So you may even want to put some fresh essential oils, a couple drops, maybe you put them on a little handkerchief or something to carry with you in your bag. So if you're feeling stressed out, you can just kind of pull it out and take a whiff and just be like, ah, thank God I'm in the zen zone again. Well, I would love to send you a free What's My Style Fashion Personality quiz. Please email me at lifesnnl. That's L as in Larry, I, F as in Frank, E, S as in Sam, N as in Nancy, N as in Nancy, L as in Larry, @gmail.com. And if you'd also like to get a copy of my book when it launches, 151 Musically Inspired Ways to Live a Luxurious and Necessary Life on a Beer and Presses Budget, please email me and I'll be sure you're the first to get it. Well, that's it for today. I hope you turn on your star power
and have your light shine as brightly as possible.
If you like this episode, please share it with your friends and family.
And don't forget to stop at www.lifesnecessitiesandluxuries.com. And be sure to pick up your free ultimate travel checklist so that you will never leave a thing behind. And remember to live peacefully, happily, lovingly, and successfully. Until the next time, namaste.
If you like what you hear, tell someone. If you like what you hear, be a dear and pass it on. Don't forget to stop at our website, www.lifesnecessitiesandluxuries.com, for more tips, tricks, tutorials to live a very necessary and luxurious life.